Hello everybody, this is Anushriya from Flavor Box in Kolkata. Today I'll be teaching you how to make pumpkin kebabs. So the idea of this recipe is to take very simple home ingredients. Our key ingredient today is pumpkin. And this is a recipe which I developed during the lockdown period where it was very difficult to get a lot of exotic ingredients. And all the things which you find here are very homely ingredients, and we'll be using three of Amul's products. We'll be using some Amul ghee, some Amul cream and some Amul dahi. So let's begin with our recipe. Shall we wait a few minutes for some more viewers to join? How many viewers do we have right now? Okay, so we'll wait for some more viewers to kind of join in. Okay. Can you just check?
It's 157.
Okay. So let's start. So we'll be doing the recipe in two steps. So first we'll make the masala for the kebab, and then we will put the kebab masala to cool. We'll make it into patties, and then I'll do a simple dip for this. So first you need to heat up your pan.
Switchboard on.
So we're just going to heat up a pan right now. In this, we will be adding 2 tablespoons of ghee. So we have some beautiful Amul ghee over here. Right? So about 2 tablespoons. So ghee is very good. We are using ghee instead of oil here because ghee, even though people consider that ghee makes you fat, ghee actually is very good fat for you. So we always prefer using ghee than using butter or oil in our cooking. This kebab is a very good item when you're entertaining, when you're calling people over. It's so healthy. In my house, we generally eat it at home for dinner along with the soup. So it's very low in carbohydrates and you get a lot of nutrients. We all know that pumpkin or what we call kumra, which is available everywhere, has a lot of nutrients in it. So I'll be using about 10 cloves of garlic, which I have chopped fine. So we'll just add this. Our ghee has become hot. So I'm just going to add this to the pan. You want to just toss it a little bit. Make sure it doesn't become too brown. To this, I have grated 1 inch of ginger. So in goes the ginger. A very nice trick is that you should leave a little bit of the skin of the ginger on when you are cooking, because the skin actually has a lot of flavor. But yes, of course, you must wash it really, really carefully. Now goes in 2 chopped green chilies. If you like it spicy, you can add a little more, or if you can't tolerate spice at all, you can simply skip the green chilies. Okay, so that's just tossing a little bit. Just wait for it to become a little brown. This adds a lot of aroma to our dish. Next, we are going to be adding our pumpkin. This is just regular kumra which we get in the market. And what we've done today is we have grated it. So when you see, we have grated it quite thick. So you use the thickest part of your grater and you grate it. This is about 1/2 kilo of kumra, and this is 5 cups that we have totally grated over here. Just toss your kumra in the pan really well. Make sure all the spices are coating the kumra. All the ghee is getting into the dish. You want all the flavor to be completely maximized. Now, in order to bind this, the kumra we see has a very, very high water content. So in order to bind this, we need to add something. This recipe is completely vegetarian. This recipe, in fact, is vegan too. Only the dip that we are using has some dairy product in it. If you are vegan, you can easily substitute the dip instead of dahi with mayonnaise. If you have any questions, please keep posting and I will answer to them. This is a very basic recipe. You can also make this with beetroot. The same way, what you do is you just parboil the beetroot, you skin it, and then you grate it in the same way, and you can follow the exact same recipe. Now we see that, you see the texture of the kumra, it is leaving out a little bit of water, and it's as we cook it, it's going to become a little mushy. So we let the kumra cook. The total time for cooking the kumra will be about 5 to 8 minutes. Now we are going to be adding, this is one aloo. This is one piece of boiled aloo. So we just mash this into the aloo. Okay, just toss it in really well. Make sure the aloo is mashed so that it kind of integrates into the kebab. This recipe we posted on our page. Please note my page is flavorbox.in. And we have been posting a lot of lockdown recipes. Very, very simple recipes and all very healthy recipes. And this was one of the first recipes I posted in the lockdown. And I have got such great reviews for this recipe. At least 20 people in Kolkata have tried it. We even had people trying it in the US, UK, and have received beautiful pictures and comments from them. So please, if you make this recipe, make sure you send me a picture and you tag flavorbox.in. Okay, now we see the kumra has mashed up a little bit, and now we're gonna add some flour to this. So this is, like you see, it's regular rice flour. So you note that we are actually not going to be adding any maida. This recipe is also gluten-free. Okay? So 1.5 tablespoons of rice flour. Okay? Mix this in really well. And another binding ingredient we are going to be using here is besan. Besan is a great versatile ingredient to use, because it's actually very high in protein. So what we've done with the besan, please note that we have dry roasted the besan in a pan. So just without oil, just constantly keep roasting the besan, turning it around in the pan, and it will, till you get a nice nutty smell. It burns really fast, so please make sure that it doesn't burn, you know. So in goes my besan. Next, what we're going to do is we're just going to add all our flavorings. Also, if you see on my page, we have uploaded pictures of all the ingredients. We have uploaded step by step of the recipe with pictures, with videos. So it'll be very easy for you to follow that. We'll also be uploading the written recipe completely, which you can take a screenshot of. So you see now how the masala has become a little tight. This really helps because we have added all the flours to this. You can see now that when we bind this thing and make patties out of it, it's going to completely integrate. Now we are going to be adding our regular Indian masalas. Okay, so this is my masalas plate. First, I'm going to be adding a little bit of garam masala. This is just homemade garam masala. There's no particular recipe. You can use any store-bought garam masala. Now we'll be adding 1 teaspoon of jeera. This is roasted jeera powder. About 1 teaspoon. And about 1 teaspoon of amchur powder or dry mango powder. Now, next we'll add a little bit of pepper powder just for seasoning, about 1/4 teaspoon, a little bit of salt, about salt to taste, about 1 teaspoon, pinch of sugar. Pumpkin is already a little sweet, so please don't add too much sugar. Just a pinch. Okay, just toss this up. You can add some herbs to this. If you want a more exotic flavor, you can add some parsley to it, fresh parsley, some fresh basil. You could also add some kasuri methi, but this is how I like it. Okay, so this is completely mixed up. Okay, next is an ingredient which makes my dish really special. So here we have some almond meal. Okay, so this is our regular almonds, our regular badam. This is about 1 cup of badam, and we have put it in the blender and see the texture. So this is really important. It should not be too fine like a powder, and it should not be too coarse. It should just be grainy like this. So 1 cup of almonds, blend it. Make sure you don't blend the entire almonds together. 1 cup, I would suggest put 1/4 cup in the blender at a go, so that you get an equal grain. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be adding half of the almond that we have blended. Okay, so just about this much. See how much you want. If you want a little less, I think it's always very important with recipes to follow the ingredients, but also you must, you know, go with the look and feel of the dish when you're making it. You know, how much almond do you want? How much crunch do you want? The adding the almond is what makes this dish really special. It adds a little crunch while you're eating. It adds a little nuttiness. So, you know, add a little more of almond. Okay. So, total about 1/2 cup or 1/4 cup, just as much as you want. So, you see how... I'll just show you the texture here. You see how the almond has come. So you get a little crunch in every bite. So this is ready now. This is our masala. The beauty of this dish is that you can pre-make this dish and keep it in your fridge. Now what you do now is, once this masala is ready, I'm just going to switch off my pan here. And I'm going to be putting this masala to cool in the fridge. So you can put it for 1 hour or more in the fridge. Just put it on a plate and spread it so that it cools faster. If you do not cool the masala, you cannot really make it into patties because it becomes too soft and watery. So now I'm going to be showing you. What we have done is we have pre-made the masala and we have cooled it. So you see, this will start looking like this. Alright, so this is about half the quantity of the masala that we have made fresh right now. Okay. So here is our masala. Now what we are going to do is, we are just going to make this into patties. So just like any normal aloo tikki that you make, so I'm going to just take my masala, mix it around. Make sure at this stage you taste the masala, and if there is anything which is less, a little bit of salt, a little bit of spice, then you just adjust that. Now is our second secret ingredient for this dish. So here I have some Sri Lankan cinnamon powder. So this is from Kia brand, but you can use any brand, or you can just take some cinnamon and just kind of dust it at home and pass it through a fine sieve and then add it to your masala. Just a pinch goes a long way. This is your secret ingredient today. So I'm just going to be adding just about a sprinkle. You see this beautiful color and the aroma is beautiful. So what cinnamon does is it will add a little bit of sweetness, and like, you know, when you serve it to your friends and family, it's not something that, you know, they'll be able to guess what has really gone in. So you mix it really well. Can you see the texture? You see how tight the masala is now? So you can really work with it, right? And when you're working with cold dough, it really helps. So you can just make these into balls now, equal size balls. I'm going to be making a couple of balls so that I can show you how to make it into the kebabs. Now what you do is you pat and make a tikki out of it. Feel free to shape it differently if you like. Now I'm going to be taking this beautiful plate of mine, and this is the almond milk. So we had 1 cup and 1/2 cup we put in the masala, so this remaining 1/2 cup just scatter on a plate, and we are going to be coating the pumpkin kebabs in this. So how I really came up with this is very interesting. So usually we see in restaurants, the kebabs taste really good and crunchy, and they are often coated in breadcrumbs, panko breadcrumbs or regular breadcrumbs, and they add that crunch which our palate really likes. But what happens is that's very heavy, it's maida, and that is really not good for our system. So in order to really adapt to that, and we all know that getting almonds into our daily diet is so important, so it's a very good substitution. So let's get our kebabs now coated in this almond. So just place your kebabs on the almonds which is there and just turn it around. So there you go, just on both sides. Make sure it's not too much, otherwise you won't be able to taste the kebab well. There goes my second one. Okay, and that is ready. So I think with the masala that you made, depending on the size of the patties, you should be able to get roughly about 20 kebabs. So here we're going to be using another fresh pan, and I'm just going to put it on my stove here, and this is the last step. We're going to grill our kebabs. Okay, so just heat your pan lightly. I'm going to be again using some Amul ghee. If you want, you can use butter or oil, but I would highly suggest Amul ghee. And the quality of the ghee that we get from Amul is really very good. So, since I'm just grilling a few kebabs, I'm just going to be adding about a little bit of ghee onto the pan, 1 teaspoon. Coating the pan really well. Just heat the pan a little lightly. There we go. I think our pan is ready now. And now we place our kebabs on it. The pan needs to heat up a little more. It's not sizzling yet. I'm just going to wait till we put in our second kebab now. Yeah. So now you hear the sizzling sound. So our pan is ready. So since the kebab is already cooked, you just need to very lightly grill the pan. So you can pre-make the patties and keep it in your fridge. And just before serving, you do this last step. Make sure the almonds don't burn. Flip your kebab as you go. What do you guys think of this kebab? Look at how healthy it is. Just pat it, turn it around. You want to get that slight brown flavor onto your kebabs. I'm just going to give it about a minute more. Don't make it on very high heat, otherwise you'll burn the almonds. If you don't have almonds, you can also use pistachios to make this more exotic. You could also use some cashews. feel free to substitute. You can in fact also use some peanuts. This is the kind of color you want to get. Yeah, I think that's about perfect. Any questions? Please post your questions on the comments. And now our kebabs are ready. So now what we are going to do is we are going to just make a quick dip for our kebabs. Here we have some Amul Dahi. So what you can do is you can just hang the dahi on a muslin cloth overnight if you want it thicker. This is just some regular Amul Dahi. And in this I'm going to be adding a little bit of cream. If you want to avoid the fat from the cream, you can simply skip it. But I think it gives a very smooth texture. So this is my cream. I have about 1/4 cup of dahi here. In this I'm going to be adding 2 teaspoons of cream to it. Just kind of mix this around. You can season it with some salt. Another great accompaniment with this dish is just some regular dhania patti ka chutney, coriander chutney that we make at home in almost all houses. To make this dip really different, I'm going to be adding some mustard. So what I'm using over here is a local ingredient. This is a kasundi, which is a Bengali mustard that you usually get only over here. And I think the idea of using local ingredients is what is really important in today's age. And also, you know, I went for MasterChef India season 6, which was the last season, which aired in 2019 and 2020. And my star dish when I showcased to the judges, which they love, was a Thai pineapple rice and an Indonesian rice using all local ingredients. So in today's world, I think it's very important to see what we have in our own backyard. And India has such a diverse culture and such exotic produce that we must really, really kind of incorporate it in our cuisine. We should just not get so led by exotic international ingredients to make dishes at home very exciting. There are so many ingredients that we just don't know how to use differently. In fact, I will tell you, one of my more popular recipes is a lauki stir fry. So using regular lauki and all the time eating lauki ka sabji at home, it gets really tiring. But if you make it in an Asian stir fry, that makes it really interesting. So please go back to my page flavorbox.in to see my other recipe videos. So we have a dip ready here. You see how the mustard has added a little bit of tinge to nice color to our dip over here. So now our kebabs are ready. We're going to be now time for plating our kebabs.
Someone is asking if they can use local mustard.
Yes, you can use any local mustard. You can use Dijon mustard or regular mustard sauce that you get in the market. And if you don't want to use mustard, you can also use some pudina patta or some dhania patta, any fresh herb that you have. So I'm going to be just adding, I'm going to just show you the plating of the dish. You can just serve it separately, but just for presentation's sake, I think one thing MasterChef has taught me is how even the visual of the dish takes things in a long way. So I'm just going to be putting some of my dip over here.
Shalini is asking for how long we can store the batter.
Shalini, hi. I think you can just store the batter, use it the same day. You could try to, store it overnight. But that is not something I have tried. I believe that, fresh ingredients is kind of what really works. And one should always eat fresh.
Whoever missed the entire recipe, you can head to @flavorbox.in to get a step-by-step instruction.
So here are my kebabs. Look at how beautiful that is. And just for plating, a little bit of freshness, some greens. Again, I have my very local ingredients here. I have some dhania patti, some pudina patti. It's just gonna make the dish a little special. You see the difference, how just adding a little bit of green has taken the dish to another level. Yeah.
Pooja is asking how the mustard paste is prepared.
So the mustard paste actually is a bottled mustard which I have got from the market. I have used brand Elmac over here. On my Instagram page, Facebook page, what I'll do is I'll send you a link to buy it online on Amazon. And also you can look up online, there are a lot of grainy mustard recipes. So you can use that. What I will do is after this video, I will look up a recipe that I think is relevant and I will post it for you. So here you go. This is our beautiful pumpkin kebabs with a mustard dip, plated beautifully for you using Amul products. I will be uploading a picture of this dish also on my page, so you can have a look, you can store it, you can screenshot it, and do share the pictures of your dish when you cook it. I'm just going to kind of, just speak a little bit about really using local ingredients so that I give you guys some time to ask any more questions that you have. This is a dish, like I said, you see A to Z, all ingredients that I have used is there in your kitchen. Probably only the mustard is not there in your kitchen if you're not in Kolkata. From the almonds to the besan to the rice flour, it is something you can, in fact, you can make it tonight itself. I would really encourage you guys to make it tonight, make it this week, whenever you have some time. And then you see how easy this was. It was so easy and it didn't even take up like about 30 minutes. Obviously, there is a little time required for cooling, but other than that, in 30 minutes, you have a dish from the pan to your table. So, any more questions or shall we sign off?
No more, okay. No more questions.
All right. Thank you. Can you just put in my page name out there on the comments so people can see?
Yes.
All right. Thank you. Namaste. And I thank Amul India for giving me this opportunity. Signing off, Anushree here from Flavor Box Kolkata. Bye-bye.